Wow, that's great.
Good day, everybody. This is Crazy Tinder, and this is my gaming world. I'm bringing you this video today basically just to talk about Kill Confirmed. It's one of the new games on MW3, as well many of you well know. And honestly, I think they have a winner with this one. I really enjoy playing this game. It's sort of like Team Deathmatch, but with a twist. Basically, when you kill someone, they drop dog tags. If your team picks up the dog tags, you get a point. If the other team retrieves their dog tags, you do not get a point. First team to 65 wins. So you can have 25, 30 kills in a game, but if those dog tags are never retrieved by you or your teammates, there's no points awarded and you will not win that match. That really comes into play when you start talking about the teamwork of Team Deathmatch. Now, one thing that some people don't know, or some people that actually I've played with and have got butthurt about, is they'll make the kill and then I'll go retrieve the dog tags for them. That's the best possible outcome for your team or you and your buddies. For game-wise, it doesn't give you any more points, but if you kill someone, when they drop, you get 50 points. If you retrieve those dog tags, you get 50 more points. Okay, you've just received 100 points. Rock on, everybody's happy. If a teammate retrieves those dog tags, like you just saw right there, I get 50 points for kill. He gets 50 points for retrieving the dog tag, and I get 50 points because that kill was confirmed. So if I kill and they someone else picks them up, that is actually 150 points awarded to your team. Doesn't sound like much, but those 50 points that they got works towards their kill streaks as well, so or point streaks as well. So I honestly, as a team, that's what you want to do. Doesn't always happen, but if at all possible, let your teammates grab them. With that though, don't just leave dog tags everywhere because one, the other team can grab them, or two, if they sit there for too long, they will disappear. Nice little three piece right there. Turn around the corner and just run over everybody. The next nuance, I guess you can say, with this game is don't go rushing around. Don't go screaming around corners. You need to take your time, watch your corners, take it slow. When you get that kill, as you can see right here, I've gotten that kill. Those dog tags are sitting right there. I don't run up there and grab them. He can have teammates around, and that's one of the real big strategies. So you can have teammates around and just sit there and wait and watch. So, take your time once you get those kills and make sure the area is clean before you rush up there. Another thing is working as a team is essential in this one. However, a team as an Overwatch, not team as everyone sits in the same building and you lose map control and things like that. I've seen a lot of times, well, with that triple that I got earlier, they're all three standing right there. By the time one of them realizes that they're dying, all three of them are killed because they're standing right on top of each other. Don't run around like that. Make sure you've got some space, make sure you've got some Overwatch, because especially with MW3, and it's happened to me more than once, one of my teammates will step in front of me, and then before I know it, he's already shot, and they've gotten a collateral with shooting me as well. Situational awareness, or map awareness, knowing where they're going to be. See, with that one, I didn't even see that guy when I originally played it, the guy that was standing behind the dumpster. Completely oblivious. But knowing where the other team is generally gonna be. And I think with MW3, that's one of the hardest things I've found so far. It seems like every time I turn around, there's a guy right beside me, right behind me, spawning up somewhere. And we've all done it too, where you spawn up and there's a guy 5 steps from you running the opposite direction. Hey, that's great for that one time, but just realize that spawns are very sporadic in MW3. So try to maintain, if your team doesn't have a UAV up or some sort of pinpoint UAV, advanced UAV, whatever the case may be. Try to figure out where your team is and where they're going to be spawning, and be sure to be facing that direction. Snipers are a good way to do this as well. Not even just a UAV. If the map has high vantage points, get some snipers up there. Realize that you're going to have to go collect their dog tags when they hit people. But if you're a team that communicates, get someone on the high positions. They'll be able to tell you roughly where the other team is, or where they're spawning, or where there's dog tags at. Here was my rushing out and getting shot. And last but not least, and I think this goes with any map, any game type, is the strike packages. As you see with this one, I'm running around with Specialist. I truly love running around with Specialist. I think it's an amazing strike package. I'm really happy that they came out with it on this one. But if everyone's trying to get those high kill streaks, realize it's not going to do anything for the game if no one's collecting those dog tags. You've seen a couple of it's the advanced UAV that drops that drops bombs. Honestly, I'm sorry, I can't remember what it's called right now. I have no idea if they got any kills. I have no idea if, we picked up the dog tags off of that. But make sure that across your team, even before the match, talk about it and find what everyone's using and get some UAVs up in there. That is all I have for this video. As always, thanks for watching. Give me a like, subscribe, many, many more where this came from. Thank you.